Thank you very much for introducing me. It is a very great honor to participate and a Giga Talk in such a nice conference. Today we talk about a confluence relations for multiple data values.
Yes.
This is a joint work with Nobuo Sato. And I first say some plan for this talk. In this talk, I give a new family of relations of multiple zeta values. And we first talk some introduction and algebraic settings. And next we'll explain the standard relations of iterative integrals. And next, we introduce confluence relations by considering the limit of standard relations. And finally, we show that a confluent relation implies regularized double shaft relation and reality. Okay. Let's start with from the definition of multiple zeta values. And zeta k1, delta kd equal defined by a series expression. And where k1 delta kd minus 1 is a positive number and kd greater than 1. And there are many relations. There are many Q-linear relations among MZVs. But there are no explicit family of Q multiple zeta values, which are proved to exhaust all linear relations of multiple zeta values. But there are some family which are conjectured to exhaust all Q-linear relations of multiple zeta values. We call such family big families. And the first big family is associated relation. And regularized double shackle relation.
Excuse
me, you are saying so linear relation groups, they are algebraic relations, no?
So we expand by Schaffer product form. And Kaufman relations. And it is proved by Khrushchev that associated relation implies a regularized double Schaffer relation and duality. And it is proven by Kaneko Yamamoto, Kaneko and Yamamoto, that regularized double Schaffer relation plus duality implies Kawashima relation. And in this talk, we give a new family of multiple Z values. A confluence relation. And show that confluent relation implies regularized double Schaffer relation plus duality. And this is an introduction. In this talk, we will introduce iterative integrals over P1 minus 4.01 infinity and variable Z. So, first, we use variable Z. And carry AC be a free algebra generated by a formal symbol E0, E1, EZ. And carry A be a free algebra generated, non-commutative free algebra generated by E0 and E1. And so, AZ is a Q vector space generated by a word of E0, E1, EZ. And we have an admissible part of AZ. This is a Q vector space generated by admissible word, where admissible word means word which does not start E0 and does not end E1. And carry A not is the admissible part of A. And we first define a Schaffer product and Stafford product. Shuffle product is a binomial map from AZ times AZ to AZ, defined by the following regression. And this definition is a very standard one. And next, we define a stuffed product. A stuffed product is a binomial map from A times AZ to AZ. And note that the definition domain of stuffed product is not AZ times AZ, but A times AZ. And appearance of this definition is not standard, but we can show that this stuffed product coincides with the standard definition of a stuffed product.
That's U star U in that last one? Or U star V?
U star V. Yes, U star V.
V.
Zero over one and B equal zero over one over Z. So A B can be defined and A B
a product. Okay, next we define the evaluation map. Evaluation map is a linear map defined by the following iterative integral.
from the definition.
Do you want less than one at the top, or that looks like it's a function of Tn?
Oh, sorry. Lw is a holomorphic function. Observe. And from the iterated integral expression of multiple zeta values. We have this. So the standard relation is a certain a subset of kernel F. And next we want to state the differential formula for F. For this purpose, we define some algebraic, some linear map, a partial alphabet. Delta is a chromatical delta of sets. And this is the definition of partial alpha beta, where alpha and b beta is at 0 over 1 over z. And we can easily check that a partial z0 plus partial z1 plus partial 1 0 equals 0 on admissible path. And Now we can state the differential formula for the integral. And this is due to Gonchar's or Pant. And they plot more. They plot the formula for more generalized iterative integrals. The formula is as follows. The differential of L dou is a sum of the inverse times L value of a partial Z delta. And similar term for one. This is a key formula for the standard for standard relation. And we can state the first our main theorems. UV is an element of AZ, and this is a formula for a partial alpha beta for scatter product. And we also have a partial alpha beta of scatter product. U is the element of A naught and U is the element of AZ naught. Especially in the second iteration is not highly is not trivial. And I finished algebra section. And I want to explain the standard relation of iterative integrals. First, we wants to consider the limit of z to infinity of L dou. But this is very simple. First, we define the const map. This is an automorphism. This is an algebraic map. Defined by this. If A equal to 0 or 1, then just send to EA. And So constant absence, the word which conclude is at sent to zero, and the word which consists only is a one, then just the identity. And then let us consider the limit of z to infinity. This is just a L value of const. The reason is as follows. Let a value is an iterative integral. And if z appears in a denominator of iterative integrals, then it is obvious tends to zero.
Is that close to infinity or to zero?
Oh, sorry. Yes, thank you. Just to infinity. And the proper entropy is a key. That for all that in AC not. Partial J 0 W equal 0 equal 0. L value of partial of W vanish and const that go to 0. Then L W is 0. The first condition says that the differential of L is vanished. And second condition says that therefore L is constant function from first condition. And second condition says that this constant is zero. Therefore, problem 1 and B, we have this problem.
Excuse me, I don't think I understand your definition of const. You defined it on a single term. Do you extend it as a derivation or what? You define it for EA.
EA.
So how do you extend it to the whole algebra?
Oh. Algebra for concatenation. So.
Oh, you just began.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
So roughly speaking, the standard relation is a relation which can be obtained by using this lemma recursively. And more precisely, IS standard relation is a minimal subset of AZ not such that 0 in IST and if IST is a minimal subset of AZ not, which satisfies these two conditions. Thank you. And from the definition, IST is a relation of iterative integral. And more explicitly, IST is a set of words which satisfies the condition. That condition is a different partial of the iterative partial of W. The constant of iterative partial of W vanish. And so this definition of standard deviation is a definition by condition. So it is not clear the generator of IST from this definition. So next I give an explicit generator of IST for the purpose we define two linear maps. Phi shuffle omega is defined by a sum where R is a non-negative integer and B1 dot BR is a zero or a Z and and phi star W is also defined by a similar way. But we consider the stuff product for instead of shuffle product. Standard deviation has a very explicit representation expression. IST is an image of ID to phi shuffle. And this is also can be written as.
Maybe there's a doubling missing in constant there.
Thank you. this is the explicit expression of IST. And it also can be written as kernel function or kernel function. Now I talk about the confluence relations. Very roughly speaking, a confluence relation is an evaluation of standard relations at z to 1. So we want to consider the limit of standard relations. So next, so therefore, first we consider the limit for general LW. The limit of z to 1 is controlled by a certain polynomial PWT. And this limit attempt to zero. And this polynomial is unique. Therefore, if W is in kernel of LW, then the constant term of PW also vanish. And And there is a natural way to compute the constant term of P double. We don't explain that a concise definition of lambda, but in some special case, a lambda is can be computed by easy way. Of course, this condition does not characterize lambda, but there are some certain natural way. So we first recall the Shackle realization. AZ is equal to this other Shackle variation. And taking a constant term. This is the definition of Shackle realization. And if W has this form, then lambda W is just a Shackle realization of replacement of W. But this means that all occurrence of EZ to E1. So this is, of course, element of A. Thank you. we can state that definition of congruent reactions, congruence reactions. This is just this is an image of standard relation by lambda. And this is from the definition, the relation of multiple data values. And it is expected that congruent relation is all relations of multiple data values. And finally, we explain the reason why congruent relation implies realized by Schaeffer relation. I put A1 as follows. So, not all the elements of A1 is admissible because there are some elements which ends by E1. And regularized double-shaft relation is the relation of particle z values defined by stacked product minus shuffled product. Where U in L1 and V in L0. And this is a relation of multiple data values. And congruent relation includes regular double-shaft relations. Thank you. And the proof, the better sketch, the proof of these theorems. First, put VZ be a replacement of all occurrence of EZ to E1. Then we consider this. This is, we can show that this is a standard relation. And we can show that this is equal to the realization of U sharp V, U sharp V. Therefore, the regularized abstract relation is contained in a complete relation from the definition. And finally, I remark that we can also show that concurrent duality concurrent relations contain duality relations. I say some key of this theorem. To prove this theorem, we used the anti-homomorphism defined by following way, where easy sense EZ and E cell sense EZ minus E1 and E1 sense EZ minus E0. This is a generalization, some generalization of duality, and this is the key of the proof of theorem. I finish my talk. The variable z are congruent with the one. We consider the iterative integrals over 0, 1, infinity, z, and I moved z to 1. So I call the congruent relation.
Two rivers coming together.
Yes.
Is this
a general homology? Yes, algebraic homology with respect to shaft product and such.
Okay. I also have two questions. So what is the intersection of the standard relation IST and A0? Is it just zero? So if you take the intersection of IST and A0, what's this? Is it just zero? So if you have the standard relation IST and you intersect it with A0,
then
zero.
Yes, it's.
Is it just zero?
It's just zero.
Okay. And my other question, always when you wrote these sets, you meant the ideal generated by these elements, right? So IRSD.
IRSD.
So you wrote it as a set, But you mean the ideal generated by these elements?
Yes, ICF concludes the ideal generated by IF, yes.
No, I think it's not known that they qualify. I mean, if you take the linear span, it's not known if it's an A0 ideal, right? So I think that's conjecture, but not known. So, but you always take the ideal generated by these. So I was wondering, in your case, ICF, you also take the ideal generated by lambda.
In ICF case, the ideal generated by the elements and the ICF coincides. So the left-hand side is ideal. You don't have to...
So in your case, you can show it, but in the classical case. And for IRST, you cannot show it.
IR is...
But in your case, you can show it.
Yes, exactly.
Other questions? Do you know anything about how the confluence relations relate to the Kawashima relation?
Of course we can show that a confluence relation implies Kawashima relation because the confluence relation implies duality and regularization. And Kanepa also shows that regularization relation and duality implies Kawashima relation. Thus, confluence relation implies Kawashima relation.
Well, let's thank the speaker again.